Hello everyone, I'm Patrick Kunzmann from the Technical University of Darmstadt, and I would like to present you the Python package Biotide for general analysis of sequence data and macromolecular structures. And now you might wonder, why not simply use BioPython for this? And this is actually where the story starts. In 2017, I found BioPython on the internet, and although I really like it, I think it lacks modern standards for scientific programming in Python, especially consequent usage of NumPy. Therefore, I proposed a modernization of BioPython into BioPython 2.0 on the BioPython mailing list. And the response was quite positive, but since almost a complete rewrite would be needed, there would be issues with backwards compatibility and some possible name ambiguity to which code base the name BioPython refers. Therefore, I continued the project in development in a separate project called BioTide, which has the same license as BioPython for possible later exchange. And then a few months later, I released the first version of BioTide onto PyPI, and a few days ago there was a current release of BioTide, so it's still in active development. BioTide is separated into four sub-packages that represent a common workflow in computational molecular biology. At first, the database sub-package is used to download data from biological databases like the RCSB or NCBI. The downloaded file then loaded into the Python object via the sequence or structure sub-package respectively. And based on the internal objects, you can do some, can apply some analysis or editing tools on this. And for methods that are not directly implemented in the BioTide package, there is the application sub-package for seamless accessing external software like NCBI Blast or Cluster Omega. Here's a small demonstration of such a workflow. In this case, we want to align two protein sequences of avidine and streptavidine, and for this we download the two sequences as FASTA files from the NCBI database. We load the sequences from the FASTA files, align them, and finally this block is for plotting this alignment with the help of matplotlib. One core feature of BioTide is a relatively high performance. BioTide objects internally are based on NumPy arrays, as I already said. Therefore, the operations on them are vectorized and C-accelerated. And further acceleration where vectorization is not possible is done via Siphon code. For example, if you look to the right here, here are the pairwise atom distances in the structure, measured. And in BioTide, this is quite fast because all coordinates are stored a single NumPy array, whereas in, for example, in BioPython, you have to iterate over each single atom instance. And this is the reason why it's a lot slower in this case. But there's still a lot of work to be done. There's a functionality I want to implement into BioTide, and for this reason, I would like to cooperate with the BioPython people to exchange some code. Yeah. Thank you for your attention. I have a poster, so if you're interested, meet me there or go onto the website. There's an example gallery where you get a small impression what you can do with BioTide. Thank you.
Excellent.